At that point, to be honest, I was low-key salty and frustrated because... I want the channel to be real and authentic, to show the journey of becoming a trader, and also show the moments where things are not as bright. This trading day was a perfect example of it, so let's review this day. So quickly on the 15 minutes, we can see that we had a gap from yesterday. Very bullish since we took out yesterday's high already. And I noted the today's low and the today's high. Not much here on the 5 minutes. So let's just go directly on the 1 minute and wait for the 9:30 open. So at 9:30, we went directly to take out today's high, which was around 8, 9 a.m. And then had a big displacement. So almost 900, but anyway, no fair value gaps here, as you can see. But on this second leg, we can see here fair value gap. We had the displacement, we had the break of the low, we have this fair value gap, and this one, the second one, which is already filled right there. And since it's past 9:55, I'm allowed to put the trade. And then we go for the first target, which is above 2.5, so around here. Let's go for a 1, 2, 3. Let's check this displacement here because I see here a fair value gap, 400. But you can see here this fair value gap. Clearly, I got missed. But if someone was to put the order at the first fair value gap, it would have been a great trade. But I don't do that. Even though ICT suggests you always do it, I just prefer going with the one higher. So since it's still before 11, let's check if we have another opportunity because we took out 2 days low. So maybe we can see some. Alright, so after taking today's low, we had a displacement of more than 600. We have the break of this high right there. And we have this fair value gap. So I have all that I need to put my order. Let's see how this one goes. And it's a loss. However, it's not over. What I'm going to show you is the difference with US500, because usually when I'm trading, I'm keeping an eye on both US100 and US500. And you remember the trade that I've put my order, the fair value gap that was at 9.52? You can see here that we didn't come back to this fair value gap. However, on US500, we did fill the second fair value gap right there. And you can see here how beautiful this one was. So even if it was frustrating, I need to take a step back and see how successful this trading strategy is, thanks to ICT. For example, there was this nice $3,200 trades that happened just last week, which I made a video about right there.